I know you guys are dying to hear my thoughts on the new Kat Von D 10th anniversary eyeshadow palette. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay guys, I have been making an attempt to switch up my, you know, format for videos, so hopefully you guys are enjoying it. I got some decent feedback, so yeah, thank you so much for all of those people that commented when I did the different intro in my last video. Anyway, I had asked you guys in that huge ass haul video I filmed right after I got back from Sri Lanka what palette you would like to hear my thoughts on, and a majority of you said the Kat Von D 10th anniversary eyeshadow palette. So I decided to test it out and I'm finally ready to give you guys my thoughts. I have worn it. I've worn every shade in the palette and I've also shown you on my Instagram stories. So if you guys don't follow me on Instagram, definitely go ahead and do that. If you're wondering why I look so orange, I did attempt to, is it called like blush contour? Blush tour? I don't know if that's an actual word, but I did pick this up in my huge ass haul. This is the Neo Blush in the shade Sunset from Kevin Aucoin. I know he has a few different ones and this is the one I picked up. I'm really into peachy blushes right now, so the trend is to kind of like contour with your blush. I don't know, I am enjoying that trend, and there is like a highlighter and it gradients to a really nice warm peachy blush, which is like my favorite thing in the whole wide world. So in case you guys are wondering what this really intense like cheek look is all about, it is the Neo Bronzer from Kevin Aucoin. A little bit pricey, but I like it. I don't think I'm gonna do like a dedicated review to that product, so I just wanted to throw it in here. So you guys are all here to hear my thoughts on the Kat Von D palette. Now of course this palette is by the brand Kat Von D, and I would definitely consider this a high-end palette. This retails for $52 and was basically created in celebration of Kat Von D's 10th anniversary. So she launched her brand, I'm assuming, in 2008, and this is the culmination of all of that work. So it's very exciting. I'm sure any brand would be so excited to have made it 10 years, and now I know Too Faced is doing their 20 year anniversary palette or something like that. So lots of excitement in the makeup industry. Now you guys all know Kat Von D, you're familiar with it. I have quite a few palettes from her, have tried it quite a few palettes from her. I also have notes on my phone, so if you guys see me looking down, it's because I'm referring to the notes on my phone. So yeah, I found this on the Sephora website. It actually launched, I think, the very next day after it launched on her website. It launched on May 5th. I believe she launched this on Cinco de Mayo. So it launched on her website on May 5th. This is listed as a limited edition palette. Now, I don't know how long this will be in stock for. It is out of stock on the Sephora website. Not sure if she's planning on restocking it or anything like that, but if you want it, you probably want to grab it so that you can get your hands on it. She also did release a collection with this. There was a train case. There's a special edition Trooper eyeliner. There is a special edition highlighter. And I believe there's a lipstick and some like gold glitter deal. If I find a picture, I will throw it up for you guys in case anyone is curious. I'm just going to talk about the eyeshadow palette because I didn't try out any of those other items. Of course, I didn't pay any shipping for this product because I did order it on Sephora, so I get 2-day shipping. I do believe Kat Von D shipping is free over $40, so you would easily hit that by picking the palette up on her website. So this palette is made in the USA and has a 12-month shelf life. Each shade is 0.06 ounces, and there are 16 shades in here. Basically, this palette was inspired by people that Kat Von D knows, and there's 16 shades, so it's 16 people that she considers her muses. So each, you know, color has a name and it's named after a specific person. I must say the campaign for this palette was beautiful. I did manage to catch quite a few of the videos featuring the muses on her Instagram and her Instagram stories, I believe, on Kat Von D Beauty. And I honestly thought it was beautiful. Like, it was a very unique campaign. She featured some very unique personalities. Some people had different like skin tones. They had different stories. There was one girl that really stood out, was this beautiful model. She had a very editorial face, something you wouldn't quite see in regular beauty campaigns. Yeah, just really, really cool, inspiring people that were kind of changing the game. So I thought that was really cool for her to kind of, you know, go outside the box and do something like that. Also, this is the box packaging. It's gorgeous. I mean, I love gold if you guys know me. And here on the back are all the shades laid out, which I should have been paying attention because I did swatch this palette and I apparently read the colors backwards because I always get confused, but apparently I wasn't paying attention. So I do apologize for that, guys. I'm still trying to get back into reviewing products because I've been gone for so long. Now, of course, Kat Von D is vegan and cruelty free, so if you are about that life, this is gonna fit right into your collection. As far as application, I definitely use the mattes dry, and then all the shimmers do apply a lot better if they are foiled, so I just use MAC Fix Plus to foil them, and it really made the palette much more intense on my eyes. Today I'm actually wearing the purple shade, which is the shade called Catherine. I just tried to like match the shades on my shirt. I wanted to film this review with an eye look that was made using the palette, so I did use this shade all over my lid. I actually really like that purple. I'm not usually a huge fan of purples, but that is a really beautiful purple. This green is honestly such a standout. It is called Leafar, and it's just the most beautiful shade in this palette. I swear, if this was a single, I would just buy the single. I love the blue as well. This is called Chad. This shade right here is called, it's called Kelly, I believe, and it's beautiful, but it's not very unique. A lot of the other shades are shades we've kind of seen before, so I, you know, wasn't really blown away by the shade selection of this palette, but I do think that it is a beautiful palette that kind of works for pretty much everyone, because if you're scared of color, I feel like there's enough color where you can do something fun, but you also have enough neutrals, and I like that she gave us some cool tone matte shades so that you can actually work these two shades in the crease with these two colors. A lot of the time, my problem with neutral and colorful palettes is that the neutrals are always really warm shades and they're always like oranges and yellows, and then you get like pops of color, but there's nothing to blend them into the crease with. So that's a huge gripe of mine. So I like that she gave us like this green and this blue, which are Lala and Caroline, to kind of blend so that these two shades would just blend a little bit better. I've seen so many gorgeous makeup looks with this palette. I want to do tutorials for you guys, but I just don't feel like that's my strength. I know there are loads of beautiful tutorial channels that do wonderful makeup looks, and I would just suggest you guys check that out. I mean, I always show my makeup if I have something like extra exciting on Instagram, so you guys can always check it out there, but I'm very simple when it comes to my makeup look, so I don't know if I'll do a tutorial on this palette. I mean, maybe if you guys like highly requested, I can consider it, but honestly, I don't feel like I'm a tutorial channel. I just like to play with makeup. I like to swatch makeup, so that's what I'm gonna stick to. Hopefully you guys don't mind. Okay, so I'm inserting this clip into my Kat Von D 10 year anniversary palette review video because one of my subscribers had asked me this question, and after I filmed the video, I totally realized I forgot to do a comparison because she had asked me how the 10 year anniversary palette compared to the Juvia's Place Magic palette, and this is what it looks like. I actually did swatches on my Instagram story, so I completely forgot to film them for the video. Now, I definitely noticed a lot of similarities in the neutral shades, not so much in the colorful shades, but let me show you some of the swatches that I thought were very comparable. So, for example, the yellow gold shade, as well as the shade Nubia from the, hey, my dog is here, the shade Nubia from the Juvia's Place palette, I think are very, I mean, not similar to the point where there aren't enough differences, but I feel like if you're on a budget and you don't need both palettes, you definitely just need one or the other. The other shade I did definitely think was similar are the two green shades. So this is the Kat Von D palette, and this is the Juvia's Place palette. Those are very similar shades. I mean, they're just different tones, but I feel like to the naked eye, you're not really gonna be that shocked. Some of the mattes are pretty similar as well. As far as the mattes, I would say this, you know, warm undertone crease shade, not the exact same tone, but I feel like Would any regular human being know the difference? I think not. And I also thought, I think I thought this shade and this shade were pretty similar. This is like that corally peachy color. I mean, they're not super similar, but I feel like there's enough similarities. Definitely the green shade I think is dupable with the Juvia's Place palette and the yellow and then the mattes. I think you can get complete eye looks from both of these palettes. So if you have one or the other, I would say you'd be good to go. I don't think you need both. You do get more product, I believe, in this one. This palette doesn't say how much is in here, but they both have equal amounts of shades, but I think you get maybe more product in here. And the Kat Von D is also significantly higher priced. So hopefully that helps with the comparison. I do see quite a bit of comparison in the palette. Now, I don't want to swatch every shade. I did do the comparison swatches on my Instagram. So if you guys are interested in really seeing that, let me know. I can put those in my highlights for you. And now I'm going to get back to the regular video. Okay, and then the million dollar question. Would I recommend this palette to you guys? Honestly, I was so on the fence about buying this palette. I flip-flopped. It launched when I was in Sri Lanka. I wasn't planning on buying it. And then I, you know, FOMO kicked in and I was like, oh, I really want to try it out. See what it's about, because I didn't really like... I haven't really enjoyed a lot of Kat Von D's new releases. Like, I bought the Metal Matte because I was like, oh my gosh, like, all of her holiday releases seem to be, like, must-buys. And I missed the Mevita Loca palette, so I was like, okay, I'm not going to miss out on any more of her eyeshadow palettes. So I wasn't a huge fan of the Metal Matte, mostly because it's a cool tone palette, and cool tones are really not my vibe. So I ended up keeping that. I have it. Then the Saint and Sinner palette, I liked, but I hated how she organized it. I like it when my palettes are like a gradient like this. It's just easier for me. So I ended up returning that, and I haven't really bought a palette from her since. You know, I'm always curious about her stuff because she seems like such a hyped brand on YouTube. And then when this collection was, you know, sneak peeked, it wasn't exactly what I was expecting. I was hoping she would give us a Mevita Loca type palette. I feel like if it was my brand and it was my 10-year anniversary, I would go like balls to the wall, because I feel like the Mevita Loca palette is like literally the most hyped palette on YouTube where people wish it would come back. So I was thinking she would do something more rad, like more radical than this, but she didn't. I think she played it safe with this palette. But honestly, if you are a big Kat Von D fan, if you're a fan of the formula, I think this is one of her better palettes that she's launched recently. Another reason why I would recommend it is because the packaging is 100%. I love this giant mirror, but still the palette is very compact, which is something I really didn't like about the Metal Matte palette. It's very hard to store. It's long and skinny. The Saint and Sinner palette was shaped like a window. So it had like a curve on the top, which again is huge and obnoxious. So this is nice because this is great for travel. It's a nice like plastic packaging. This cover art was done by her. So it's just like an iconic palette. I think it's going to be one that, you know, people are going to reach for year after year because it's beautiful. Now it does have a 12-month shelf life, so I can't attest to how long it's going to last. But I think that if you're looking for a high-end, neutral palette with a few exciting colors, I think this is going to be for you. Is this like the end-all be-all of all palettes? Like, do you need this in your life? Absolutely not. But if you're a fan of Kat Von D or if you're a fan of something like this, I would definitely recommend it. I don't see any problems with the formula, anything. None of the shades are patchy or, you know, nothing like that. I don't have any problems with it. So I really think it's worth the splurge. And yeah, that's all my thoughts on this palette. Okay guys, that is everything I wanted to share with y'all about the Kat Von D 10th anniversary eyeshadow palette. If I missed anything, definitely let me know in the comments down below. I'd be happy to, you know, try and find the answer for you guys. I am not the, you know, end all be all of reviewers. I just wanted to come on here and give you a few of my thoughts from a tan girl perspective. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. I do upload every other day. I haven't been doing a very good job of keeping up with that schedule, but I'm going to try, guys. Summer is definitely a beautiful time here in Fargo, so I might not be as consistent, but you know, once that cold weather kicks in, I'd be more than happy to sit inside and review makeup for you. I know I have a bunch of other new palettes to test out as well, so keep watching because there's lots more reviews to come, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.